In this problem, we're asked to balance the redox reaction below in acidic solution. In this redox reaction, we see copper metal reacting with aqueous nitrate ions to produce aqueous copper 2+ ions and NO2 gas. We begin by identifying the oxidation states of each atom on each side of the equation. Since copper metal is in its free elemental state, we know that it has an oxidation state of 0. In the nitrate ion, we know that the oxygen is going to be minus 2, and there's 3 of those. So in order to get an overall charge of minus 1, the nitrogen must have an oxidation state of plus 5. On the product side, the copper 2+ ion will have an oxidation state of plus 2, whereas for the NO2 gas, if we assume that each oxygen is negative 2 and there's 2 of those, then the nitrogen must have an oxidation state of plus 4 to balance the 4 negative charges. Next, we break down the redox reaction into its 2 half reactions. We see for the copper that we have copper 0 on the reactant side and copper 2+ ions on the product side. That's an increase in oxidation state, which means that this is our oxidation half reaction. For the reduction half reaction, we would have nitrate on the reactant side and NO2 gas on the product side. Since the nitrogen underwent a decrease in oxidation state, that indicates that this is the reduction half reaction. Now we can balance the atoms in each half reaction. We'll begin with the oxidation half reaction. In this case, we have one copper on each side of the half reaction, and so it's balanced. Since there are no other atoms, we don't have to do any other balancing of atoms for the oxidation half reaction. For the reduction half reaction, we see that there's one nitrogen on each side of the half reaction. There's 3 oxygens on the reactant side, but just 2 on the product side. This means that we'll have to balance the oxygens by adding an oxygen in the form of water on the product side. Once we've added water on the product side, we've added hydrogens to the half reaction. So now we have to balance the hydrogens by adding 2 hydrogen ions to the reactant side. Now we have 2 hydrogens, 1 nitrogen, and 3 oxygens on each side of the reduction half reaction. Now we can balance the charges in each half reaction. In the oxidation half reaction, we have an overall charge of 0 on the reactant side and an overall charge of plus 2 on the product side. This means we'll have to add 2 electrons to the product side to cancel out the 2 positive charges so that we have an overall charge of 0 on each side of the oxidation half reaction. For the reduction half reaction, we see that we have 2 hydrogen ions, which are positive, and 1 negative nitrate ion for an overall charge of plus 1 on the reactant side. For the product side, we have neutral NO2 and neutral water. Therefore, we have to add 1 electron to the reactant side, so we have an overall charge of 0 on each side of the reduction half reaction. Now we have to balance the electrons in the half reactions. Since the 2 half reactions have different numbers of electrons, we'll have to multiply the reduction half reaction by 2 in order to get the same number of electrons in the oxidation and the reduction half reactions. Once we've done that, we can add the half reactions together. For the oxidation half reaction, we have Cu solid going to aqueous Cu2+ and 2 electrons. For the reduction half reaction, we have 2 electrons plus 4 hydrogen ions plus 2 aqueous nitrate ions produces 2 NO2 gas and 2 H2O in the liquid phase. When we add these together, we see that the 2 electrons will cancel since we have the same thing on the reactant and the product sides. Nothing else will cancel. Therefore, the overall redox reaction that's balanced will be Cu solid plus 4 aqueous hydrogen ions plus 2 aqueous nitrate ions will produce the aqueous copper 2+ ion, 2 moles of NO2 gas, and 2 moles of water in the liquid phase. We can now check our atoms to make sure everything is balanced. We see that we have 1 copper, 4 hydrogens, 2 nitrogens, and 6 oxygens on each side of the equation. We should also check the charge, and we see that on the reactant side, we have an overall charge of plus 2, and on the product side, we also have a charge of plus 2. After watching this video, you should be able to balance redox reactions in acidic solution.